All right, I'm back. We are on page 6 of note 7, Calc AB. I mentioned in the very first video, but I haven't mentioned it since then. I'm actually only really doing the first 6 pages here because those are the 6 pages that are actually my original notes. The remaining pages, if I have time in life, I will do them eventually. They're all old FRQs. And I think, unless I'm mistaken, let me check right now. Yes, on my website, which is turksmathstuff.com, I have a list of the FRQs that I do with my class after we finish these parts of the notes, this part of the notes. Definitely they're worth doing. I just don't want to put my time and effort into that right now. But I might do it at some point in the future, so who really knows? But anyway, this is the last page of the notes that we'll actually be doing in these videos right this minute. But anyway, let's get started. So this question is, to my eternal shame, the only thing that I ever clearly remember telling a class they didn't need to worry about that did definitively end up on the AP exam. I actually know exactly when that happened because it turns out this is one of the exams that they released to the public. So we're going to talk about the shadow problem, right? So it's like the day before the exam, I was like, any last minute questions? And somebody was like, can we just go over the shadow question like one more time? And I was like, psh, hasn't been on the exam in years, not worth our time, don't worry about it. And then let me show you something. Everybody came back from the exam, they're like, oh, turns out the shadow problem was on it. Look at this. It's like an XKCD type picture, too. Person whose height is 6 feet is walking away from the base. You can find this exam on, I don't know, on a it was on AP Central. I don't know what they're calling anything anymore. And also, like with AP Classroom, I don't know what they're hiding behind a like soft paywall now where like the payment is registering for the exam. Who knows? This exam is publicly available though, so you can definitely find it. It's 2012 multiple choice. So, person 6 feet tall walking away from the base of a street light along a path at a rate of 4 feet per second. If the height of a street light is 15, what is the rate at which the person's shadow is lengthening? And I was just like, don't even worry about it. But anyway, let's do the problem that's in the notes and we'll worry about it right now. And then, you go back to it right before the exam, you give it like a once over. It's not super hard, just like you want to remind yourself. So let's see, this is the problem that I have. A 5 foot tall woman walks away from a 16 foot tall street lamp at a rate of 5 feet per second. Is that reasonable? I don't know. I didn't really work that out. Find the rate at which her shadow grows. All right, let's draw a picture and see if we can figure out what's happening. So I'm actually gonna draw, if you know me, I like to draw my triangles not this way, but I'm drawing it this way because I feel like walking away means walking to the right. I don't really know why I feel that way. But I do. So then I'm going to draw the light going to her feet first, and then maybe I'll switch colors and she'll be purple. Okay, so this is the setup of the problem. And she's 5 feet tall, so this is five. And the lamp is 16 feet tall, so this is 16. And we are looking for, so there's a couple of things here, right? So she's walking away at 5 feet per second. So this is where she is. So she's here. She's walking away at 5 feet per second. So this segment right here, which I'm gonna call Y, no, I should call it X. X is growing at a rate of 5 feet per second because she's walking away at 5 feet per second. Like that's her distance from the lamppost is increasing by 5 feet per second. So there you go. So I'm going to say dx dt is equal to five. Positive five because it's getting longer over time. Now the question is find the rate at which her shadow grows. Or in the context of the actual AP question, her shadow is lengthening. So I'm going to say that her shadow is actually this line segment. So it's not the hypotenuse. Some people mistakenly think, I don't know what they're doing in their lives. Some people think that their shadow is like the hypotenuse in this situation. Like, how is that your shadow? That's not your shadow. Your shadow's on the ground. So that's her shadow. And so the question that we're looking for is find, we want to find dy dt. We know dx dt is 5. We're trying to find dy dt. And then when are we trying to find it? So it doesn't matter. when we're trying to find it, it turns out. It's just a universal constant. It doesn't make a difference, right? So we need some kind of geometric thing that we can do here. Well, I see two triangles. I see a big triangle and a small triangle. And so let me try to highlight this. My big triangle, kind of like here. I'm pretty sure everyone can see it, but I'm going to do this anyway. I wonder if it'll straighten out highlighter. Oh my God, it does. But it does such a good, does it? Ooh, that's a nifty thing. Will it always straighten? What the heck? All right, so I'm trying to highlight this. You gotta take joy in the simple things, you know? So this is our big triangle. I also see a smaller triangle, which I will use a different color for, and perhaps actually a thicker highlighter. So the smaller triangle is here, to here, to here. Now, this isn't a geometry lesson, but they share a right angle. They both share that like base vertex angle there on the far right. So by angle, these are similar triangles. So since they are similar, we can say that, what can we say? I'm gonna say that y over 5, right? So the horizontal part to the vertical part of the small triangle is equal to the horizontal part, which is x plus y, over 16. And that's gotta be true, right? Because they're similar triangles. So this is by similar triangles. And then we could just dive in and find derivatives here, because I think it's gonna be easy enough to do. So I'm gonna do that. Derivative with respect to time of this. So go d dt of y over 5, d dt of x plus y over 16. Okay, so here it's 1/5 dy dt, and here it's gonna be, I'm gonna take out 1/16 just in total, and then I'll have a dx dt plus a dy dt. I'm also gonna show you a different way to answer this question, which is like honestly faster, but like I never think to do it, so I worry that other people also wouldn't think to do it, because I always assume that I will do it the best way possible, which is not always true. Now what can we do? We can plug it. Take a look at what happened here. It actually doesn't matter what x is. It doesn't matter what y is. It just matters what dx dt is. That will tell us dy dt. Isn't that kind of crazy? I mean, I think it's kind of crazy. So we need to be able to substitute. We're looking for dy dt. So there's a dx dt. Oh, I gotta change that. Hold on. That was way too, what'd I lose? Parentheses. Okay, that's one thing that never happens in the real world. You never accidentally delete something in the real world. Like when you're handwriting, you're not like, oh, I accidentally erased that. Like, doesn't happen. But we know what dx dt is, positive 5. So let's do this. Get 1/5 dy dt is gonna be, I'm gonna say 5 over 16, because I substituted, plus 1 over 16 dy dt. So, all right, 5 over 16 is going to be, I'm going to make it 1/5 minus 1/16, and then I'll simplify that. Dy dt, this is a 6, does not look like it. Now it really doesn't look like it, so let's delete. There we go. All right, so 16 minus 5 is 11 over 5 times 16, and then dy dt. So I could have multiplied 5 and 16. It's 80. It's not like a big deal. But when I cross multiply, the 16s are going to cancel. So like, why do it to myself? So dy dt. All right, so it's going to be 25 over 11, right? Because I bring up the 5, I cancel the 16s, I divide by 11, 25 over 11. That's how I think that through. And then our units are going to be feet per second. You can almost always find the unit. Oh, I was in the way. You can almost always find the units right in the problem. So if you go back and look when you're a little confused about the units, like more often than not, they're right there. So I get this. So this is one attempt. So I'm going to do it a second way. And the second way is a little bit faster, but it requires you to be a little more clever with your geometry. So I'm going to redraw the picture over here. So we get this. Oh, do you see that? It like jumped up so that it could like match it. I don't feel like this is a horizontal line, though. I don't know if it is or not. I guess it is. I don't know. And then here. Then I'll just use the same color because we kind of know what's... that was not vertical. It's like it snaps to a line, but then it does... It doesn't really have... Ooh. I don't know if you could not see that. It gave me like this blown up... I don't know. Like a microscopic version of what was happening there. Microscopic, meaning it made it look as if I was looking in a microscope. I feel like microscopic means really small, but it like blew it up. Whatever. Okay, so this is 5. Now, I know this whole thing here is 16, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a line that is parallel to the base that goes across. So I think that's good. I don't know. So this is also 5, which means that this is 11. Okay, so how does that help? Well, I'm going to borrow the variables that I used. So this was x and this was y. But this is also x because it has to be. That's a rectangle, right? So opposite sides are equal. So now if you look at this, we actually have two similar triangles that like didn't really exist before. So it's, I'm trying to find like a good size. This triangle is similar to this triangle. And it's less obvious, but it's true. And I'm not gonna work out the geometry. Well, you know, it's angle-angle again. But you have parallel lines cut by transversal, corresponding angles are congruent. Like, I don't teach geometry, but every once in a while you want to kind of think about it. So that means in this picture that I'm going to go horizontal over vertical. Horizontal over vertical equals horizontal over vertical. We're looking for dy dt, so I'm just going to say y is equal to 5 over 11 times x. Derivative with respect to t, dy dt is 5 over 11 dx dt. And then we know, because it was given, what color did I use for that? That weird kind of purpley, I don't actually know what color that is. That one maybe? No, that's too dark. Does it matter? Probably not. You gotta obsess over the little things. So we knew this, it was given, right? It's 5. So this will tell me that dy dt is 25 over 11 feet per second, and it's so fast. That method is so fast if you think of it. And you are way less, that highlighter is way too small. And you are way less likely to make a mistake if you do it this way. However, you have to remember that you can do it that way, and I am not that great at that. All right, let's take a look at this next part, which I think is the last part. It is. Okay. So find the rate at which the tip of her shadow moves across the ground. This is not the same. So we have... We're going to draw one more picture, or the picture one more time. And don't be afraid to do that. Like, if you need to redraw the picture multiple times, obviously do it. So we called this X, we called this Y. Now, the rate at which the tip of the shadow moves across the ground, that's like saying, what's the rate of change of this, right? Because this is the tip of her shadow. And it's moving at a rate that is not just based on dy dt, it's based on dx dt and dy dt. We're really trying to find the rate of change of x plus y. That's like our goal, right? But this is dx dt plus dy dt. In my experience, this is far less common a question, but we know both of these because we've either been given them. So we were given this up above. We know that's 5. And then we solved for this in two different ways and got the same answer, thankfully. So this is actually just going to be 5 plus 25 over 11. Slightly different problem, so it's a little weirder. So that's 55, 60, 80 over 11 feet per second. And that is our answer to that question. So it's a little different. You have to think it through. The one about the length of her shadow is like a million times more common. not a million, but more common. All, very few things are a million times more common than anything else, certainly mathematically. Anyway, I made a specific video about the shadow problem, which you could find here if you're in the market for more of that. There's a playlist of related rates videos also somewhere. I mean, that video is definitely in it. And if you're in my class now, you're about to do like a lot of old FRQs. If you're not in my class, maybe at some point you'll watch me do them. Otherwise, go to my website, find the list, search them up on the internet. You'll find them. You'll find their solutions written out. They're all old enough that you can get like a single PDF that has like almost all of them in it. I definitely recommend you check that out. And I hope you have found this video helpful. And I will maybe see you in the next one. So, yeah, see you then.